Good evening, this is Tina. How are you doing? In this video, I'm going to talk about a column annotation. And we can use in column annotation to specify additional values for each column. Okay, so let me give you some example. We won't cover all the cases, okay? So here I still continue using the demo. If you watch my previous video, probably you already see this one. And here for this ID, by default, it's gonna be what? It's gonna be the column name gonna be the same as the field name, right? If you don't want to have ID as the primary key, okay, you can use in column to specify. Okay, I want to change to using person ID as a primary key column instead of a default one. Okay, this is a column. And suppose for the first name, by default, when we're using string, the length for string is 255, right? And also you can change the length. Like suppose for this one, we can add a name. Yes, let me use first, okay? And also let me use in length. I can use in limit 50 for the first name. You can also do something like this. Private, suppose for this one, I have an email. And the email for the person has to be unique. You can also use in column. Yeah. C-O-L-U-M-N. And here have a unique, you can equals to true. Okay, so this is there are other options with the column. We can take a look at later. So now let me run, okay? Let me run and we will see exception. Okay. Okay, when we run, it will have some exception throw. Specified key was too long. Maximum key length is 1,000 bytes. And this happened is we want to add a unique constraint on the email. This is because to add those indexing or unique constraint on a column in MySQL, the maximum length is 1,000 bytes. And by default, the string is 255, right? So one character is 4 bytes. So the maximum for the email should be not more than 250. So you're using 1,000 divided 4 is 250. So now we have to change the length by default is 255. This length is more than allowed. Okay, you divide 4, the maximum is this one, like 250. And when we run one more time. Okay, you can see no errors. See, auto table add unique constraint. And when we create a table, you can see it's not ID anymore. It's the person ID and it's not the first name, it's the first. You can see for the last name, default string, right? For the last name, default is 255. And for the first name, we change it to be 50. So here you can see it's 50. And when we go to the workbench, let's run this one again. Okay, you will see person ID, email first, last name. And if you take a look at the index, unique index, everything is added successfully, right? Okay, so let me go back to the ID. Suppose I change it to be 251, then it's gonna fail. Okay, just to show you, it must be less than 200, less than or equal to 250. Okay. You can see here, specify the key, two is too long. So the maximum, if you want to add for the string value, make sure you have a length there. Otherwise, you're gonna have the syntax error when you create. And column, it has other attribute, okay? Or you can specify. It has a name, it has unique. You can also optionally can have newable, insertable, updatable. You can also have other column definitions like the length or others. And table, we'll talk about later if we want to have a secondary table, okay? The length we talk about. This one is for decimal, okay? Decimal, the columns, if you want to have some precision, which is the numbers after the dot, right? You can also using the scale, okay, for exact numeric columns, okay? So anyway, if you need a column, just take a look at API and choose the right attribute to specify the additional value you want. That's it for the column, and thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.